Hi and hello to all. This side Priya Rana and this is the second lecture of logistics. So earlier we have done about the origin of logistics, meaning of logistics and the objective of logistics, and now we are going to learn about the functions of logistics. The very first function is order processing. In order processing, what we have to do is firstly we receive the order, then we record the order, then we fill the order and assemble all the order details for transportation. In this process, we have to see that what we are ordering, we have to order that accurately and we have to order that within time. The reason being, if the wrong product or the same product with different specification is supplied to the customer, it may lead to cancellation of the original order. If the original order get cancelled, there will be a loss of cost in that. So moving on to the second one, warehousing. In warehousing, what we have to see is we have to store the products, we have to assort the products. What is the meaning of here assorting? Assorting means, say this, if I say that this rack here, it contains all bottles of different sizes, say small size, big size, or medium size. This rack contains all the bottles of different sizes, different colors. So this is assorting, a mix assorting. If I say in words, assorting is group of similar things that are different in sizes, colors or qualities. So warehousing refers to storing, assorting products in order to create time utility. What is time utility? Time utility is you have to provide the product with easy availability to the customers within time. Okay. Next, talking about inventory control. In inventory control, if I say that a firm has 100 unit of product in a stock, but the demand is only for 10 units. You have 100 units, but the demand is for only 10 units. See, in 90 units, what amount of cost you have invested, that is all wasted. So if you have invested this 90 units cost at some other place, you could have gained interest on it, you could have gained some extra money on it. So for that you have to check that, you have to keep a check on the inventory. Okay, moving on to the next one, material handling. In material handling, you have to check the movement of goods within the warehouse. It involves handling of material in such a way that warehouse is able to process the product, the orders efficiently. That means in order, your material handling, you have to place the products at right place so that whenever you need it, whenever there is an order of the process, you can easily fetch that product in less time. Next is transportation. In transportation, you seek to move goods from the point of production to the sale, to the point of consumption. That means the goods are to be moved from the point of production to the sale of the consumption of the quantity. Okay, transportation, if I say, it is very easy. We also know the same concept that in transportation, what happens is from the firm to the consumption place, we move the goods. Next, in packaging. So in packaging, we have to take care of the two things. First is one which the customers see on the shelves of the supermarkets or hypermarkets. What they see? The attractive packaging of the product. That's what they see. And the other thing is that the other thing is packaging where the products are packed in bulk, so to avoid the breakage and spillage. The second, the main use of packaging is when you are packaging the products in bulk, you have to check that there is no breakage and spillage of the products. Moving on to the next. In information monitoring, what you have to see that the information that you are collecting about the orders, it should be up to date, on time, and there shouldn't be any waste of time and there shouldn't be any discrepancies in between. Next, the facilities, what facilities you can provide to the customers, or in between, what facilities you can see in your logistics activities. Say for example, if in material handling you see that there is a need for maintenance of the machine, there is a need for testing of the same product, there is a need for more storage or in your warehousing. So these facilities you have to check in logistics. Moving on to the next, that is salvage and scrap disposal. What happen in it is, see, the reverse logistic, as the name denotes, deal with the planning process and flow of finished goods, inventory, material, packaging material and part of finished goods back from the end customers to the product company as the sales return or warranty return or unsold inventory with trading partners. So in this, what happen is, if the product is in warranty, so if there is any problem in that product, it comes back to the firm. Then if the trading partners couldn't able to sell that product in the market, then also it comes back to the firm. So in this way, in logistics we have to take care of salvage and scrap disposal also. In procurement, if I talk about procurement, what does it mean that we have to procure the goods? Okay, so in this, if I say that whatever you are procuring, you have to see that you get the needed goods and services, the goods that you need, you have to check out that you procure such goods which is needed in the business and at best cost and cheapest if possible. So these things you have to take care of when you're procuring the goods. Moving on to the next, parts and service support. Say for example, if you are in an automobile company, then you have to see that it's the part of the car, the part of the new cars, you have to take care to that in the coming next years you have to keep a stock of the parts of that particular model of the car. So in parts and service support, it means that you have to keep a stock of the parts of the goods you are serving to the customers. So this the meaning says that equipment that has been sold must be maintained, the product that you have sold, it should be maintained. That means that you should take care of its maintenance. Suppose if I have purchased a scooty from the Hero Honda company, then after purchasing, if there is any problem in my mudguard, I have to let it check to the company that can I have a repair of the same mudguard that has been given to me firstly on my newly purchased scooty or not. I have to see and check such kind of a things. So that's all from my functions of logistics. Thank you.